Hey, Mr. Mike, welcome back to Keel. How are you this morning? Thank you for taking time for us.
Hey, Robert, great. I'm on the way to the airport headed back to D.C., but I heard you all talking about this big case, and it is a big one, and want to give you a little insight on it.
Well, the headline is Supreme Court set to hear critical Louisiana abortion case, and I promise we're going to veer back into that and your history and your association, your history with that in a second or two. But Erin wanted to bring something up because as she was writing the news story this morning, she looked at me and she said, I had to rewrite the story. I said, well, you rewrite most stories. And mm-hmm. she said, well, you tell Mike.
Well, it was an Associated Press piece, Mike, that was so slanted, I was almost shocked. And I thought, this is sad. I'll read you the last sentence and you tell me if you feel the same way. A Supreme Court case set for arguments Wednesday could lead to the clinic's closure. We're talking about the Hope Medical Group. And more fundamentally, a retreat from protecting the right to abortion that the High Court first announced in 1973. Do you find that sentence as slanted as I did when I saw it?
Yes, there is always a bias when you're talking about this issue in the mainstream media outlets. They do this to us all the time. When I used to litigate these cases routinely, we called it the abortion distortion. It really is a slant that you get on all every reporting on a case or a situation like this. And we've seen this since this law was passed by the Louisiana legislature back in 2014. The whole point of the case, the argument that will be held at the Supreme Court on Wednesday, I'll be there. We've been anxiously awaiting this day. Is this statute that was passed in bipartisan fashion by Louisiana legislature back in 2014? I think there were only maybe six or seven dissenting votes in the entire legislature. It was authored by my dear friend Katrina Jackson, who is an African American Democrat mm-hmm. Out of the Monroe area, and the reason it passed with such a landslide bipartisan majority through the legislature is because it's a common sense law. It's a regulation on the abortion industry that says if you're going to be an abortion provider, if you're going to perform abortions, you, Mr. Doctor, Mrs. Doctor, you've got to have admitting privileges to a hospital within 30 miles of your clinic. Now, did Katrina Jackson author that bill and did the legislature pass that bill because they wanted to shut down all the clinics in the state? No. On its face, it says this is about the health and safety of the women who are seeking this dangerous procedure. They have a long, long record of terrible abuses and filthy, unsanitary conditions in the clinics and substandard practitioners who do this. And so we had to do this to protect women's health. It was challenged. I was one of the lawyers in the court that defended the state's law back in 2015 before I got elected to office. And Kyle Duncan was my co-counsel. He's now a judge on the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Fifth Circuit. But it's taken this long to make its way to the Supreme Court. Finally, we get our day. It is high stakes, but I think that is misleading.
Mr. Mike, if memory serves, there was a similar Texas law that went to the Supreme Court, and the high court found they said they shot the law down. What's the difference between the Louisiana case and the Texas case?
There are several. That was the case the Supreme Court decided in 2016, and the reason this one is it could really be such a landmark is for a couple of reasons, Robert. Number one, this is the first abortion-related case that the High Court will hear since Supreme Court Justices Gorsuch and Kavanaugh have joined the court. And so that is a sea change in the majority. We now believe we've got at least five of the nine justices in the Supreme Court who would affirm the sanctity of every human life, and ultimately they may get the chance to do that. But this is the first, kind of the case of a first impression for those two new justices. But the differences between the Texas case and ours is that their statute was a little bit different. It did have a huge effect in Texas of closing down most or all of the clinics, and that's a big, broad area. But if you look at the geographical region of Louisiana, it's a smaller state. Less abortion providers could cover the state as the courts look at this, and there's some other distinctions. This statute was not drafted to shut down abortion clinics. It was drafted to ensure that the health and safety of women is protected, and that is a reasonable pursuit of a state because the state has a legitimate interest in that. We've been arguing these pro-life cases. I've been defending these for 20 years. This is one of the most sound cases that we've ever had before the court to defend on its merits, and I think we're going to win it.
Mike, the Hope Medical Group has a doctor with admitting privileges. one that has had that pending, but it's they don't anticipate that being approved. Will this leave the Hope Medical Group as one of the only abortion clinics that would still be able to operate in Louisiana? And if that's the case, will we become even more so the abortion capital of the South?
Well, that's the risk, Aaron, and it's a great tragedy of living in Northwest Louisiana and in our cities, Shreveport and Bossier, is that this is the abortion capital of the state. And part of that is because it's a regional hub, as you know, because we draw people from Texas and Arkansas and even Oklahoma here. We would love to do something about that, and that's why I founded the Life March that we do up here every year. We're trying to draw attention to it, and thankfully, by God's grace, the numbers of abortions have been going down gradually over the last several years here. But that could be the eventuality. They argued in the case when we were arguing this, I was defending the law in the district court back in 2015. They argued, you know, the sky's going to fall. All the clinics in the state will close down. Look, that's not the state's problem, okay? That's not our problem. They have to get, if they're going to provide this dangerous procedure, they need to get people in the clinic who are qualified to do it. They don't need to bring in substandard so-called doctors to do these procedures who harm women, period. And the state has an interest in protecting the health and safety of women as long as abortion is legal. And I want it to be illegal. I hope someday soon the court will overturn it. But until that day happens, the state has an interest and a responsibility to protect women, and that's what this is about.
Let me ask you this, Mike. This case could not ultimately lead to a complete overturn of Roe v. Wade. That's not where this one's going, correct?
Probably not, but it will be an indication of the where the court is on these issues. One of the other big issues, and this is important to note, in this case is that the court has allowed argument on a second issue, not just is our regulation legitimate and to be upheld, but also do abortion providers themselves, does the abortion industry, do they have standing to bring challenges to legitimate, reasonable, common sense health and safety regulations that are passed by the states and the courts? Or does it have to be people that are actually involved in it? That is a big issue. And if the court rules in our favor on the standing question, that could be a major sea change in abortion-related litigation going forward for years to come.
How long before you expect the ruling on this?
Probably by summer. We would expect about the June time frame, I believe. The oral arguments are Wednesday morning at 10 a.m. Eastern, and there'll be a high anticipation about that. Liz Merle, who's the Solicitor General for Louisiana, works in Attorney General Jeff Landry's office, will be making the arguments, and I'll be right behind her, and I wish I could do it myself. But when you're in Congress, you don't get to do that anymore.